Could these cutbacks take a bite out of you? News 5's John London explains how slashing the budget for animal control could affect how they protect you. John?
Well, travel time, Jack. It's simply taking the SPCA longer to get to the nearly 1,000 calls for service every month.
He's got the whole West Side to himself today. A typical situation for this animal control officer, and the odds are against him. Hamilton County has one for every 120,000 people, and Sergeant Brandon Corcoran, with piles of paperwork required for every call, is it today. Out of 30 calls for service, he'll get to maybe 15.
Well, that's what I wonder. You can't get to them all, right?
No way you can get to all of them, he tells us. So far today, he's been on an injured deer run near 275, a loose dog complaint in Price Hill, several calls for strays, and a check for an abandoned dog in a building here on Queen City. The afternoon's barely begun. Last summer, SPCA had 70 staffers for the work here. In this season of recession, they're barely at 50, a slim staff for a heavy demand.
We've notoriously been underfunded and undermanned, and now it's even more so because of the recent recession.
The cutbacks, they tell us, are affecting enforcement. As you listen to this, SPCA is able to have two control officers in the field covering all 460 square miles of the county. No matter how much they bark about it here, there's no indication of any additional funding anytime soon.
Well, I guess we have to do the best we can with what we've got to work with.
And with the deep cuts of the past year, SPCA is relying more than ever on its volunteers and labor from the River City Correctional Center to help with on-site cleaning, a situation, Cherie, that's far from ideal.